Hello students, welcome to my maths classes. Today we are doing class 12 NCERT chapter 5, that is continuity and differentiability, and this is exercise 5.1 question number 23. Find all the points of discontinuity of this function, and your function is defined as sin x upon x when x is less than 0 and x plus 1 when x is greater than or equals to 0. Now, to find all the points of discontinuities, we have to first consider our function, and our function is defined as sin x upon x when x is less than 0 and x plus 1 when x is greater than or equals to 0. Now, we know that the domain of f is the whole real line. So we have to check continuity on the whole real line. Let us take case 1 when x is less than 0. When x is less than 0, your function is defined as sin x upon x. Now, we know that sin x being is a continuous function. And x being a polynomial function, it is also continuous. So, we can say that the quotient of two continuous functions is also a continuous function. So, fx is continuous for all x less than 0. In this interval, your function is a continuous function. Now, in case 2, we are going to check continuity at x is equals to 0. And when x is equals to 0, to the left hand side, the function definition is different, and to the right hand side, the function definition is different. So, we are going to find left hand limit first. So, limiting value of your function as x tends to 0 minus is when to the left of 0 your function is defined as sin x upon x, and limiting value of sin x upon x as x tends to 0 is equals to 1. Now we are going to calculate right hand limit, that is limiting value of your function as x tends to 0 plus. Now to the right of 0, your function is defined as x plus 1. So by direct substitution we can get our right hand limit, that is also 1. Since left hand limit is equals to right hand limit, so we can say that limiting value of your function as x tends to 0 is equals to 1. Now we are also going to check the exact value of your function as x is equals to 0. And when x is equals to 0, your function definition is x plus 1. So your value is 0 plus 1, 1 is. And now, since limiting value of your function as x tends to 0 and is equals to exact value of your function when x is equals to 0, that will implies that your function is continuous at x is equals to 0. Now we are also going to check when x is greater than 0. So in case 3, we are going to check when x is greater than 0, and when x is greater than 0, your fx is defined as x plus 1. Your fx is defined as x plus 1. And being a polynomial function, your fx is continuous everywhere, and it is also continuous for all x greater than 0. Now case 1, 2 and 3 will implies that your fx is continuous in its domain. So we can say that it is a continuous function. Your question number 24 is, determine if fx is defined as x square into sin 1 by x when x is not equals to 0 and is equals to 0 when x is equals to 0 is a continuous function. So you have to check this function for continuity, and for that you have to first consider our function fx is equals to x square into sin 1 by x when x is not equals to 0 and fx is equals to 0 when x is equals to 0. We know that the domain of your function is the whole real line. So we have to check continuity on the whole real line. So we are going to take our first case when x is not equals to 0. In this domain, we are going to check continuity. So let us take an arbitrary real number such that c is not equals to 0. Now, we know that the limiting value of your function as x tends to c is equals to, when x is not equals to 0, your function is defined as x square into sin 1 by x. So, your fx is x square into sin 1 by x, and limiting value by direct substitution we will get sin x c square into sin 1 by c, which is a finite quantity. Now we are going to also find the exact value of your function at x is equals to c, and that is equals to c square by direct substitution. We will get this only. Since limiting value of your function as x tends to c is equals to exact value of your function, so your fx is continuous at x is equals to c, and x is equals to c was an arbitrary real number, so your fx is continuous for all x not equals to 0. And in case 2, we are going to check continuity at x is equals to 0. So consider case 2 when x is equals to 0. And when x is equals to 0, we are going to first calculate limiting value of your function as x tends to 0. And that will come from the function x square sin 1 by x. And it will give you 0, x square will give you 0, and sin 1 by x as x tends to 0, 1 by x tends to infinity, and sin infinity, sin 1 by x will be any number in between, sin of anything lies between minus 1 and 1. So, jab aap infinite input de rahe hain, at infinite input, you will get any oscillating number between minus 1 and 1. So this will be any number between minus 1 and 1. So 0 multiplied by any number is equals to 0. Now we are also going to calculate the exact value of your function at x is equals to 0, and that is defined as 0. Since the limiting value of your function as x tends to 0 and exact value of your function as x is equals to 0 are equal, so your function is continuous at x is equals to 0. And these two cases will implies that your function is continuous in whole of its domain. So, it is a continuous function. Now, question number 25 is, examine the continuity of fx is equals to sin x minus cos x when x is not equals to 0 and minus 1 when x is equals to 0. So we are going to check this function for continuity. And for that, first of all, consider our function fx is equals to sin x minus cos x when x is not equals to 0, and fx is defined as minus 1 when x is equals to 0. So the domain of your function is the whole real line. And to check continuity, we will first consider a case when x is not equals to 0. So let us take, when x is not equals to 0, your fx is defined as sin x minus cos x. And in this interval, when x is not equals to 0, sin x itself is a continuous function and cos x also is a continuous function on the whole real line. So it is also continuous in this domain, x is not equals to 0. So your function is continuous and the difference of two continuous function is also a continuous function. So your fx is continuous in this domain for all x not equals to 0. So we are supposed to check our continuity at x is equals to 0 now. And when x is equals to 0, we are going to first calculate limiting value of your function as x tends to 0, and that is equals to sin x minus cos x. By direct substitution, we will get sin 0 minus cos 0, and that is 0 minus 1, that is minus 1. And exact value of your function when x is equals to 0 is defined as minus 1. And since your limiting value of function as x tends to 0 and exact value of your function when x is equals to 0 are equal, so your function fx is continuous at x is equals to 0. And these two cases will implies that your function is, fx is a continuous function. Your next question is, find the value of k so that your function fx defined as k into cos x upon pi minus 2x when x is not equals to pi by 2, and your fx is equals to 3 when x is equals to pi by 2, is continuous at x is equals to pi by 2. So we are supposed to find the value of k, and you are given that your fx is continuous at x is equals to pi by 2. And if your function is continuous at x is equals to pi by 2, this will implies that limiting value of your function as x tends to pi by 2 is equals to exact value of your function when x is equals to pi by 2. When x tends to pi by 2, your function is defined as k cos x upon pi minus 2x, and f pi by 2, when x is equals to pi by 2, your function is defined as 3. Now if we directly substitute x is equals to pi by 2, we will get 0, numerator will become 0 and denominator will also become 0. So it will become 0 by 0 form. So we are going to substitute x minus pi by 2 as h, where h will be tends to 0. So it will become limit h tends to 0 k, x will be replaced by pi by 2 plus h. And if we replace x by pi by 2 plus h, we will get limiting value of as x h tends to 0. K, cos pi by 2 plus theta is minus sin theta. Okay, and this will be pi will cancel out and you are left with minus 2h. Okay, now minus will also cancel from numerator and denominator, and k by 2 can be taken out, and sin limiting value as h tends to 0, sin h by h, this limit will become 1. So your k by 2 into 1 is equals to 3 will implies that k is equals to 6. Question number 27 is, find the value of k so that your function fx defined as kx square when x is less than equals to 2 and 3 when x is greater than 2 is continuous at x is equals to 2. So we are given that your function fx is continuous at x is equals to 2, and this will implies that limiting value of your function as x tends to 2 is equals to exact value of your function when x is equals to 2. Since to the left of 2 your function definition is different and to the right of 2 your function definition is different, so limiting value will come when left hand limit is equals to right hand limit. And this is your right hand limit. And limiting value as x tends to the left of 2, your function definition is kx square. And to the right of 2, your function definition is 3. And by direct substitution, we will get 4k is equals to 3. And the value of k is 3 by 4. Your next question is, find the value of k so that the function fx is equals to kx plus 1 when x is less than equals to pi and cos x when x is greater than pi is continuous at x is equals to pi. Now we are given that your function fx is continuous at x is equals to pi, and if your function is continuous at x is equals to pi, this will implies that limiting value of your function as x tends to pi must be equals to exact value of your function when x is equals to pi. And since to the left of pi and to the right of pi the definitions are different, so limiting value will exist if the left hand limit as x tends to pi minus must be equals to the right hand limit as x tends to pi plus, and to the left of pi your function definition is kx plus 1, and to the right of pi function definition is cos x. Now by direct substitution we will get k pi plus 1 is equals to cos pi. Now what is cos pi? Cos pi is minus 1. So k pi is equals to minus 2 and your value of k is minus 2 by pi.